Welcome to St. Elizabeth St. Bridget Parish on the 17th Sunday in Ordinary Time. We pray that as a parish, we may become a bridge to bring people into the loving embrace of Jesus. Our Mass is being offered for Anna and Joseph Maffa and Joseph Justonic. The Mass readings and prayers can be found on page 269 in the Missalette. Please silence all cell phones.
Our opening hymn is number 577, Come My Way, My Truth, My Life, number 577. Please stand.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Coming together as God's family to celebrate our precious faith, let us call to mind our sins and ask our Lord Jesus for his mercy and forgiveness. I confess to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Kyrie eleison,
Christe eleison,
Kyrie eleison,
Kyrie eleison.
Peace to people of goodwill.
We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory.
Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father,
Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son,
Lord God, Lamb of God,
Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world.
Have mercy on us,
you take away the sins of the world.
Receive our prayer, you are seated at the right hand of the Father.
Have mercy on us,
for you alone are the Holy One,
you alone are the Lord,
you alone are the Most High,
Jesus Christ,
with the Holy Spirit
in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Glory to God in the highest, and earth peace to people of goodwill.
Let us pray. O God, protector of those who hope in you, without whom nothing has firm foundation, nothing is holy, bestow in abundance your mercy upon us, and grant that with you as our ruler and guide, we may use the good things that pass in such a way as to hold fast even now to those that ever endure. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
A reading from the second book of Kings. A man came from Baal-Shalisha, bringing to Elisha, the man of God, 20 barley loaves made from the first fruits and fresh grain in the ear. Elisha said, "Give it to the people to eat." But his servant objected, "How can I set this before 100 people?" Elisha insisted, "Give it to the people to eat. For thus says the Lord, they shall eat and there shall be some left over." And when they had eaten, there was some left over, as the Lord had said. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
From the letter of St. Paul to the Ephesians. Brothers and sisters, I, a prisoner for the Lord, urge you to live in a manner worthy of the call you have received, with all humility and gentleness, with patience, bearing with one another through love, striving to preserve the unity of the Spirit through the bond of peace, one body and one Spirit, as you are also called to the one hope of your call, one Lord, one faith, one baptism, one God and Father of all, who is over all and through all and in all. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. The Lord be with you.
And with your
spirit. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. John. Jesus went across the Sea of Galilee. A large crowd followed him because they saw the signs he was performing on the sick. Jesus went up on the mountain, and there he sat down with his disciples. The Jewish feast of Passover was near. When Jesus raised his eyes and saw that a large crowd was coming to him, he said to Philip, "Where can we buy enough food for them to eat?" He said this to test him, because he himself knew what he was going to do. Philip answered him, 200 days' wages worth of food would not be enough for each of them to have even a little. One of his disciples, Andrew, the brother of Simon Peter, said to him, "There is a boy here who has 5 barley loaves and 2 fish, but what good are these for so many?" Jesus said, "Have the people recline." Now there was a great deal of grass in that place. So the men reclined, about 5,000 in number. Then Jesus took the loaves, gave thanks, and distributed them to those who were reclining, and also as much of the fish as they wanted. When they had their fill, he said to his disciples, "Gather the fragments left over, so that nothing will be wasted." So they collected them and filled 12 wicker baskets with fragments from the 5 barley loaves that had been more than enough for them to eat. When the people saw the sign he had done, they said, "This is truly the prophet, the one who is coming into the world." Since Jesus knew they were going to come and carry him off to make him a king, he withdrew again to the mountain alone. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
So let's see if I can get this story right. It was a price should, because it only happened this week. There's an event that happened. A brother priest told me the story. He went to visit his aunt at the hospital. She had gone there by ambulance because she had some sort of breathing issues and things like that. So his elderly aunt in her 90s, off she went to the hospital, was there for maybe 5 days. So her nephew, the priest, went to visit her. And when he walked in, she had all kinds of things over her face and so on. But she realized it was the priest, her nephew, and she said, "Why are you here? To give me the sacrament of the dying?" He said, "And we don't call it that anymore. We call it the sacrament of the sick." "Whatever. Are you here to give me that sacrament?" Well, absolutely. I'll give you that sacrament, the sacrament of the sick, and also confession, and also you can receive Holy Communion, which she did. And then I guess it was time that some of the other cousins were there, her children, and it was time for her to get organized to leave. So the people came in, doctors, nurses, and so on, and they said, well, you know, we firmly believe that the next step for you is going to rehab before you go home, because we're afraid you might fall. I'm not going to rehab, she said. Not going. But you might fall. I can fall into rehab, I can fall in the hospital, or I can fall at home. I prefer to fall at home. Bring me the papers, she said. I want out of here. Her nephew, the priest, said, you know, maybe you should listen. It's probably a good idea that you go to rehab. Nope. In fact, why would you even ask me to do that when I have all the power I need now that I've received not only one sacrament, but two sacraments, and in fact, three sacraments. So I have all I need, don't need anything else. Case closed. Pen? Home she went. Home she went, and she's there as we speak. If we look to our own strength, our very limited resources, we realize very soon, don't we not, that we are barely able to manage the weight of our burdens alone. However, when to our weakness is added the strength and the power of God made available to us in Christ Jesus, then great things can happen for us and in fact through us. And that's really the point that this woman in her 90s was trying to make. And that's really the point of the gospel tonight. Notice in the gospel that the young boy, you've heard this gospel many times before, the young boy surrenders his limited resources, 3 barley loaves and 2 fish, puts them at the feet of Jesus to feed the incredibly large crowd. Andrew, the brother of Peter, observes, what good are these for so many people? And the point is well taken, but he's not looking to Jesus. He's looking to himself, to us humans. But when we look to Jesus and surrender ourselves and even our limited resources into the hands of God, we will often find that the impossible happens. Many of you have been doing this for years, surrendering into the capable hands of God. I do this daily, surrender the crosses that are mine into the capable hands of God. Monsignor Pelayo, each and every day, surrenders everything into the capable hands of God. And the burden which seems so unbearable can suddenly be carried. The problem suddenly loses its grip on us, and like the hunger pains that grip the 5,000, the problems sometimes seem to disappear. And even if they don't, we know that they will not defeat us, because we are people of God. We are children of God. We are people of faith. We are followers of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. He gives us everything we need in this sacrament and in the other sacraments. Our Lord performed the miracle with some bread and a few fish in order to take the edge off of the need for food that overtook so many. He does that and even more, I say to you, at each and every Mass. Take and eat, take and drink. Where before there may have only been discouragement and despair, there is hope. Hope and joy when Jesus touches the seemingly simple and insignificant things of life. 5 barley loaves, 2 fish, become the means of preventing starvation, as it were, for 5,000. Bread and wine, simple gifts, transformed into the body and blood of Jesus Christ. They become the means to our salvation. And what happens? In the gospel, we see that there was so much left over that they filled 12 wicker baskets with fragments from the 5 barley loaves. At every Mass, we see something similar. We receive, each of us, everything we need in terms of the fullness of Jesus in Holy Communion. And there's an abundance left over to feed others with the fullness of Jesus as well, including those among the sick and the homebound. So you see, it's here where we celebrate the Eucharist that we participate in the real miracle that's foretold in the gospel today. It's here where the hand of the Lord feeds us, to use the words of the responsorial song. We, the hungry and sometimes weary people of God, are fed by the Lord Jesus with bread in the wilderness of our earthly pilgrimage. That daily bread for which Jesus taught us to pray. We seek the nourishment, the strength of Jesus daily. At least I do, because I can't do this alone. We can't do this alone. We seek the support of Jesus as we journey toward our heavenly homeland. And in the culture in which we live, you and I must be lights in the darkness for so many others. And we draw others into Jesus, into Christ, one disciple at a time, one person at a time, through our love, through our service, through our charity, through our example, and most especially through our prayers. In the meantime, we pitch our tents each night, a day's march nearer to our eternal inheritance that hopefully we all look forward to, our inheritance with God. God bless you. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried and rose again on the third day. In accordance with the scriptures, he ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. And now let us offer our prayers to God, who answers all our needs.
That the Holy Spirit may help all members of the church to live in a manner worthy of their baptismal call, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those in our parish discerning a vocation to the priesthood or religious life, may they be confident in our love, support, and prayers. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For an end to the wars in Ukraine, Israel, and Palestine, may God's peace and justice prevail over all war-torn countries and for peace in our country. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That our generous God may ensure that all who are hungry be fed. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the Lord may help those of us gathered here to bear wrongs patiently. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That all who have died may be invited to the heavenly banquet, including Robert Armando, Bob Trebus, Carol Duffy, and Denise Robinson. And at this Mass, we remember Anna and Joseph Maffa and Joseph Justonic. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the prayers we hold in the silence of our hearts. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer, and we remember all those with heavy crosses to bear. May God grant special healing, and in a particular way for our pastor, Monsignor Paleo. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
God, our loving Father, you provide food for the journey. Hear and answer the prayers we offer you this day through Christ our Lord.
Amen. The ushers will now come forward for the Sunday collection. St. Elizabeth, St. Bridget Parish depends on your kind, sacrificial offerings. Please be as generous as possible. Thank you.
Our offertory hymn is number 764, Praise and Thanksgiving, number 764.
Praise and Thanksgiving.
Brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Accept, O Lord, we pray, the offerings which we bring from the abundance of your gifts, that through the powerful working of your grace, these most sacred mysteries may sanctify our present way of life and lead us to eternal gladness. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right. It
is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, almighty and eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For out of compassion for the waywardness that is ours, he humbled himself and was born of the Virgin. By the passion of the cross, he freed us from unending death, and by rising from the dead, he gave us life eternal. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
full, full of your glory. Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and giving thanks broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking in the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity. Together with Francis, our Pope, and James, our Bishop, and all the clergy, remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and with all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your holy will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer each other a sign of Christ's peace. Peace of God always. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
One cup of blood.
O sacred banquet in which Christ is received, the memory of his passion is renewed, the mind is filled with grace, and a pledge of future glory is given to us, God. Let us pray. We have consumed, O Lord, this divine sacrament, the perpetual memorial of the passion of your Son. Grant, we pray, that this gift, which he himself gave us with love beyond all telling, may profit us for salvation through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Thank you.
The Knights of Columbus will be collecting food and monetary donations next weekend. Please take home a copy of the parish bulletin. Thank you.
Thank you. And please continue to pray for Monsignor Paleo, and certainly you can add my name to your list as well. And please know that we continue to pray for each and every one of you. And maybe we should pray for the woman I mentioned in the homily. I hope she made the right decision. Do you know any older people who make decisions that sometimes are not always the right decisions? We all know people like that. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Mass is ended. Let us go forth in the peace of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
Our closing hymn is number 661, The Church's One Foundation, number 661.